गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन। इन ज्योग्राफी स्टैंडर्ड 8 वी हैव कंप्लीटेड चैप्टर 3 मिनरल्स एंड पावर रिसोर्सेस। आंसर द फॉलोइंग क्वेश्चंस। ऑल ऑफ यू हैव राइट डाउन इन योर नोटबुक। आई हैव गिवन, एमसीक्यूज आर गिवन। टुडे वी आर राइटिंग गिव रिजल्ट्स। इन दैट फर्स्ट एनवायरमेंटल एस्पेक्ट्स must be carefully looked into before building huge dams. For that, answer is write down. Building huge dams poses destabilization of the natural habitats of plants and wild animals living in the area. These environmental aspects should be looked into before building dams. Now I again repeat the answer. Building huge dams poses destabilization of the natural habitats of plants and wild animals living in the area. These environmental aspects should be looked into before building dams. Now come to the answer 2. What is the key reason? Second, write down. Most industries are concentrated around coal mines. Now answer, write down. Presence of coal mines around industries reduces the costs of transportation and also ensures easy availability of fuel. Presence of coal mines around industries reduces the cost of transportation and also ensures easy availability of fuel. Now, third reason, key reason. Petroleum is referred to as black gold. Petroleum is referred to as black gold. Petroleum is a very valuable fossil fuel. Write down the first point. Petroleum is a very valuable fossil fuel. It is used for running all machineries transport vehicle from a bicycle to an aeroplane. What is the answer? Petroleum is referred to as black gold. Give reason. First point you write down. Petroleum is a valuable fossil fuel. It is used for running all machineries, transport vehicles, from a bicycle to an aeroplane. Come to the core. Coring. QURRYING. Coring. Coring can become a major environmental concern. Copy the fourth number. Coring can become a major environmental concern. Now here is the answer. After coring, coring is a method, one type of mining, drilling to get the mineral, one type of method coring. After coring, pits, जो खड्डे होते हैं, are not covered, so they may cause environmental hazards . So after coring, pits are not covered, so they may cause environmental hazards. Now, after that, come to the next exercises. Fourth number, distinguish between the following. Exercise 4, distinguish between the following. Always keep the habit of writing distinguish. Make two columns. First one, conventional and non-conventional sources of energy. Write down conventional sources of energy. Here, non-conventional sources of energy. Then you make two partitions, divide the page. Write down first point. Under the conventional sources of energy, write down the first point. Conventional power sources, conventional, write down the first, the meaning, what it means. The conventional sources, power sources are those that have been in use for a long time. Conventional power sources are those that have been in use for a long time. And here, non-conventional power sources are those power sources are those power sources that have come into use recently due to the depleting conventional resources and growing awareness. Non-conventional power resources are those power sources that have come into use recently due to the depleting conventional resources and growing awareness. Now write down the second point. The same line, give the number two examples. Fossil fuels and firewood. Here under the non-conventional sources of energy, what are the examples? Solar energy, tidal energy, wind energy, nuclear energy, geothermal energy, are the different types of non-conventional power sources. Now again repeat, write down the first point. Conventional power sources are those that have been in use for a long time. What are the examples? Fossil fuels and firewood. Non-conventional sources of energy are those power sources that have come into use recently due to the depleting conventional resources and growing awareness. Now what are the different examples? Solar energy, tidal energy, wind energy, nuclear power, geothermal energy are the examples of different examples of non-conventional sources of energy. Thank you very much.